collaborations between artists and engineers can change the course of history. When you look at what happened during the Renaissance, it's amazing. Now, the question is, how can you produce that again?
The focus of the Artists at Large program is to embed artists in the School of Engineering who were already asking a lot of the same questions that scientists and engineers were asking, but coming at those questions from very different ways.
Artists now, they are almost provocateurs. They are people who expand your thinking, transform, reveal, provoke. When we brought Dario Robleto, we wanted someone curious. And Dario, I thought he was such a person.
Science is proceeding at a pace that it far outruns known ethical discussion or problems. We can't get off the hook with it's down the road. It's right now, and we need to talk about it.
For my work, the conversations I've been having with Dario have revolved around how to actually implement the technology for society, particularly when it's funded by society, which most of science is. Those are questions that I would love to say that I think about on a daily basis, but I didn't until I started speaking with Dario and realizing how we could be thinking about our science.
It's really putting the emphasis on the process of learning how we think, and the humanities can aid in this.
We're very interested in creating a technology that lets people monitor their own water quality. You know, I really did think it was a pretty clean win.
Tell people, hey.
And then just actually in the process of talking, realizing it might mean something totally different to somebody else where they have no choice but to drink it. And they're now faced knowing that they're consuming contaminated water. These are deep, like, societal issues.
You know, what do we mean by the natural?
Every interaction with Dario has left me feeling more excited about what he does and about what I do. What those conversations have done is give pause to focus on what we really think is important.
Dario is our Socrates, you know, challenging us to go beyond and ask us to ask ourselves different questions.
One thing I often argue to scientists is that we're both, at some level, trying to increase the sensitivity of our observations. And if you can do that as an artist, it's probably going to be a pretty good one. And if you can do that as a scientist, it's probably going to be a pretty good one.
This program is really in its infancy right now. We don't really know where it will go. But it's a bit like when a scientist goes into her laboratory and has no idea where her experiment may lead, but she pursues it and pursues it and pursues it out of curiosity, a desire for knowledge.
It's not something that you are going to see the benefits immediately. Maybe you are lucky and you'll get one idea that you can incorporate in your work, but it's more of an investment for the future. The analogy will be that I give you a lit match, and what I hope is for a forest fire.